Myself, Dr. Surendra Mohan Mathur. I am working as associate professor in the community medicine department. And today I am going to discuss a very important topic, the preventive pediatrics. The question is that why this is important to know about this particular group. Why? Because the population of this group is about 71% of the total population of the developing countries. And at the same time, if we talk about India, this group, the mother of childbearing age 15 to 45 years and the children under 15 years of age, they constitute a major group of say 57.5%. So this way we see that it's a major group which requires a special attention for their healthcare delivery. Now the question is why this is a special group and should be taken as a separate group, because it has got some particular features like vulnerability of this group. The risk is connected with childbearing. In cases of female, they are at risk of some medical problems because of their pregnancy. And similarly, for the children, they have a risk of growth development and survival of the children is affected. So this is a particular group which requires a special attention. And if we see the figures, we will find that in developing countries, 50% of all deaths are of above 70 years of age, while in developing country like India, it is 50% of the this pediatric group dying. So it is again a thing to be remembered. Now, present strategy is to give the healthcare delivery system to this particular group of mothers and children is through the primary healthcare or primary healthcare delivery institutes like PSC and sub-center. These are the two institutes which are providing primary healthcare to the community. So, there is no, the main function of PSC, as you know, is MCH care or mother and child health care. So the thing is, sometimes we talk about why these two should be taken as single unit. The answer of this is that during antenatal period, the fetus is a part of mother for about 280 days. It is fully dependent upon the mother. You see, if mother is healthy, the child is healthy. Secondly, if any disease mother is suffering from, then the disease is transmitted to the child. So they are closely related with each other, and sometimes you see if the mother is suffering from disease, the child may be premature or stillbirth or abortion may take place. So again, it is important to take them as a single unit. As we see the syphilis, German measles, and any drug intake problem with the mother is naturally transmitted to the fetus or the children. After birth, the child is dependent upon mother for at least 6 to 9 months, since we know that absolute breastfeeding is recommended for this period. So whole nutrition, whatever the child is getting, is out of from mother. The mental and social development is also dependent upon the mother's care to the child. Then if mother dies, the child suffers from maternal deprivation syndrome. It's a group of problems which the child faces if mother dies untimely. What happens? The socially, mentally, and medically, all the three ways are affected of the child, and we call it maternal deprivation syndrome. Then sometimes you see, again, if we talk of puerperal period or the care of the mother after delivery, say up to 42 days. That is the postpartum period. So in that period also we cannot separate the child from the mother. So again we have to look a common health care plan for them. Then we come to neonatal care. What is neonatal care? You see, again, neonatal care is the care which is imparted to the child immediately after delivery. Again, it is important. You see, why? The first week of the life is most crucial period of the child. 61% of all infant death. You see, infant death means the death before 1 year of life. So you see, it's a very high figure. Nowadays it is around 30 per thousand live birth. If 1,000 birth takes place, out of them 30 children will not be able to reach to their first birthday. So it's a very big figure, and we see that 61% of the all infant death occur within the first month of the life. So it's a important or a crucial period. Again, the risk of death is greatest during first 24 hours and during the first week of the life. So it's important to take care of early neonatal period. Then what are the object of this neonatal care? Most important is establishment and maintenance of cardiorespiratory function. You see, first of all, after birth, we look for the heart and lungs, whether heart is running all right or not, and the lung is able to take respiration or not. So it is very important. Secondly, we want to avoid hypothermia. The body temperature is to be maintained. If that temperature is not maintained, the child will die of hypothermia. Then thirdly, avoidance of the infection is again important. You see, so many deaths occur because of some infection, say for umbilical abscess or meningitis or pneumonia. These are the common infections which do occur in the early days of the life. Then fourth consideration is establishment of satisfactory feeding regime. And fifth, early detection and treatment of the congenital acquired disorders. You see, so many diseases are there which are transmitted from mother to child, and you see like your imperforated anus, or some infections like syphilis or meningitis, these may be from the mother to the child. Then congenital infections like toxoplasmosis, rubella, human herpes virus 1-2, then human herpes beta virus, then syphilis, or compositely we can say torch virus. So these are viral infections which are transmitted from mother to child. So they require special attention, and they are the cause of high mortality rate in neonates. So what is to be done? Immediate care of the child after delivery, clearing the airways so that the child is able to take proper respiration. For clearing, what we do? We do clearing of the airways, of the mucus and secretions. You see, mucus or whatever amniotic fluid the child has taken inside during the passage or during the process of labor, that has to be cleared so that the child is able to take respiration. So for that, what we can do? We take a proper position of the child. Immediately we take the child and just do upside down so that secretions are there, which were there in the say air passages or in the buccal cavity, they are out. So positioning of the child is very important. His head should be low, and so that the secretions could be drained out. Then gentle suction to remove mucus and amniotic fluid. We can use a soft suction rubber tube so that we can take out the secretions out. Then resuscitation becomes necessary if natural breathing fails to establish within a minute. In case of babies who have already been subjected to hypoxia during the labor. So it is important to establish the air passage cleanliness, and the air should go inside freely. Then resuscitation may require sometimes by mouth to mouth breathing, or sometimes by oxygen mask, or sometimes intubation may be necessary for this purpose. And if we see that if the heart is not beating up to 5 minutes, then the child may die. So we are in danger of that. So we should try to first of all resuscitate the heart and lung. Then a very important measure is Apgar score to see the condition of the child, whether it's normal or it is in danger of life. So Apgar score is taken at 1 minute and at 5 minute after birth. It requires immediate and careful observation of the heart rate. So these are the parameters which are used to form this Apgar score. One is heart rate, second is respiration, third is muscle tone, fourth is reflex response, and fifth is color of the infant. So these are the five things which we look for to establish the Apgar score of the infant. Each sign is given a score of 0, 1, 2. Depending upon the achievement of that sign, we give marks 0, 1 and 2. And it provides immediate estimate of the physical condition of the baby, so that we know the child is physically well or not. A perfect score should be if the infant is